Devin AI will replace software engineers. This has been a common headline of many articles. Will it actually? Devin AI is marketed as the first AI software engineer. So what makes people scared of Devin AI? In this video, we will uncover the marketing of Devin AI, the fear behind AI as a software engineer, and expert-backed ways how exactly we need not be as scared as the media wants us to be. Cognition Labs, the creators of Devin AI, describe it as the first AI software engineer ready to build alongside you and independently complete tasks. Devin AI backed their claims with a demo and data from Sweetbench. When tested on the Sweetbench, a dataset designed to evaluate a system's ability to write real-world code and solve GitHub issues automatically, the company claims Devin successfully resolves 13.86% of issues, exceeding the previous highest unassisted baseline of 1.96%. With all ambitious claims made around Devin, the hype usually follows, which is always welcome when you are an AI startup trying to secure funding. First up, with all the hype around AI, you should be very critical of what you believe the capabilities of AI to be. Please remember that companies leading AI development at their core are running a business and are in the business of selling. So their marketing is very eye-catching and often fear-based. Fear-based marketing is often used by honing in on an apparent threat as perceived by a target audience and using that fear to drive a response, with the ultimate goal being to secure funding. The statements such as, AI will replace software engineers, are attention-grabbing, as seen in the headlines, and therefore would generate a handsome amount of investments and a return on those investments. After Cognition Labs released the Devin AI demo video, several media outlets discovered the liberties that were taken while compiling the video. The demo seemed to stage. Cognition Labs had seemingly cherry-picked tasks for the AI that it was already trained on. In the demo, Devin merely clones the repository, installs dependencies, and runs the website. In another demo, the response to a query made to Devin seems to be more than 24 hours late. More importantly, software engineering is not just about creating websites or writing code as the AI is demoed to be able to do. It involves a deep understanding of the client and the nuances of their needs, building the architecture and crafting creative solutions. Creating software that is effective often requires creative problem-solving. And just because AI can do creative tasks does not make it a creative problem solver. From the demo, Devin looks more like an AI coding assistant that is good at switching around multiple tools. And if the term coding assistant sounds familiar, that's because it is. Coding assistants such as GitHub Copilot have existed for a while now and they look very similar to Devin. They are helpful tools and merely help the software developer. In fact, GitHub Copilot is used by 1.3 million developers. While a co-pilot can generate code, Devin can do the reviewing, running, and shipping of the final product. However, the question remains, how good is it? So let's look at some numbers. The model solves 1 out of 7 GitHub issues unassisted. This is nowhere near the output that can replace even junior software engineers, let alone the experienced ones. The space of AI coding assistants and co-pilots is extremely saturated, so the media campaigns of AI developing companies need to employ outlandish claims and fear-based marketing for people to invest in and use them. People and companies need a nudge if Cognition wants them to switch from AI assistants that work more seamlessly with their setup to Devin. There are tons of AI coding assistants such as Tab9, SourceGraphs Cody, Amazon Code Whisperer, among others, already used in the industry. Claiming to be able to completely replace software engineers is one of the very few possible methods to launch a successful AI tools dev startup. The question of whether AI will replace us or not is distracting us from real progress. What we should be asking ourselves is what LLMs can do and what we want them to do so they add to our lives and futures. The industrial side of software engineering requires information about the business as well as the industries that require software engineering. Info that most people do not have access to. So please try to be skeptical of the news and companies and people who talk about the future of AI in absolutes. With this kind of uncertainty comes a certain level of fear or anxiety. Please understand, that's normal. These changes will make us anxious because humans don't love uncertainty or change. Your Pinterest board saying the only constant in life is change doesn't make it any easier for us to give up on wanting to be stable and certain. Humans are built for survival, and at its core, the rise of AI has been portrayed to be a threat to our lives. So understand, it is natural to feel anxious. But too much anxiety is paralyzing, according to Dr. Mary Alward, a practicing psychologist in Washington, D.C. To strike a balance, here are three simple steps to stop being afraid of AI, according to experts from the Scientific American. Number one, understand the context. This is not the first, nor will it be the last time people have been scared of new tech overthrowing them. Histories are witness that our species has progressed. Economies have shifted, but the worst things portrayed by the media have thankfully not happened. Number two, try the tools yourself. If you do not have the technical understanding to do so, watch an expert try them. We fear what we do not understand, and since we get most of our AI news from media campaigns and outlets that benefit from using outlandish statements like Devin AI replaces software engineers, we risk falling to their fear-based marketing. So stay informed from reliable resources. Since you're already watching this video, you're closer to being less scared and even having a healthy and proportional skepticism and fear of AI. Number three, focus on your own actions. This can look like talking about AI actively in your community. This way you advocate for policies. You might learn new skills so you can become more adaptable in your career. Use your AI anxiety to propel yourself forward. Psychologist and behavioral scientist Dr. Saneya Okamoto says meaningfully confronting fears over AI might begin with building solidarity, finding community, and coming up with collective solutions. This is Miss Paws, signing out. Make sure to follow for more interesting content.